Hi guys, in this video I'm going to do a hammer technique with a gray background instead of white. But I said I would yesterday when I was doing the hammer technique and I was dipping, I was like, there's got to be a name for this. So someone on Acrylic Pouring Basics on Facebook, her name's Margaret Wiebe, hope I'm pronouncing it right, hammer dip and smash. Isn't that the greatest name ever? Hammer, dip, and smash. So I wrote it down so I wouldn't forget it. So thank you, Margaret. Hammer, dip, and smash is the most fabulous name I've heard of for this. I don't know if I'm going to use it today, but I'm thinking I should only use it so that I can just say hammer, dip, and smash, because it's just kind of powerful to say. So I've got gray. I mixed up black and white. So that was a toughie. Just kidding. And I'm going to use magenta, it's Liquitex Basics, Floetrol and water. If I can open it, metallic purple, which is Artist Loft. And I might use my favorite, orange. My canvas, I've got taped on the back. You can see already the paint from the pour I just did is on, just keeps it a little bit cleaner. And I am actually going to mix up some paint for you. Just using this Craft Smart Pool Blue. I haven't used these craft paints in a long time, but this color looked pretty. So, I mean, it could be like, I don't know, it's not that old, maybe 5 months old. Shake it up, and ooh, get all the dried paint off it. I'm only mixing up a little bit. Oh, I am not using this because it is, maybe it's older than 5 months, because that is full of big, thick, nasty chunks. So we're not gonna use that. Show you how to mix it and everything. You're gonna get like a whole lesson out of me, but not with that one. So now I'm gonna use some pre-mixed Liquitex Basics in blue. I quit using the craft paints a while ago and pretty much just use like Liquitex when they're on sale at Michael's. Plus I work, at a public school, so Michael's gives teachers discounts, which is awesome. I think it's 15% for teacher discount. So I can use that. Can't use that on Doorbusters, but you can use that on all the others. So I'm going to, where was I? All right, and these two, I'm gonna put silicone. And these two I'm not, because they are pre-mixed in there, and I don't want to dirty up another container by pouring a little bit in just to put silicone. So there will be enough WD-40 in these two to do what I want it to do. All right, here's my gray. So, I've mixed it up. Voila. It's White House paint, Dutch Boy. And then the black paint I showed in another video is just this black, which is gone now. It's empty. I've tried to avoid going to Michael's. I've tried to avoid purchasing any art materials, and I've been doing pretty good. I don't think I've been to Michael's in probably 10 days, which might be a record. They probably thought I died, because I always go to the same one. Well, there's two kind of equal distance for me, but there's one of them I prefer, and kind of gets embarrassing when you're going in there every single day thinking I should just get a job there. But then I probably wouldn't even get a paycheck. I'd probably just spend the entire thing. Years ago, when I was young and in college, I worked at a department store. And anytime there were sales, we'd call each other in various departments and we'd run up and use our store card. And I don't think I ever got a paycheck there. But I got lots of great deals. As I said, now I work at a school, so I really can't spend money there. Which is probably a good thing. Actually, they do have a school store, and I do buy their t-shirts. So, there's that. Alright, oh my gosh. So I'm going to, I'll start with the blue. Not a huge fan of baby blue, powder blue, however you want to say this color. But it does look great with gray. Ooh, you know what? I'm changing my colors up. I'm going to, because with the gray, I'm going to do the teal. Didn't you know? It's times like this that I really wish you guys could talk back to me and tell me what to do. I do want to use pink just because I absolutely love this color. I should look in the Liquitex bottle to see what the actual color is, because I'm pretty sure it doesn't just say pink. It's probably got some official name. Just a tad, and I decided I'm just going to use this because I just want a little bit of glitter. Some of you have talked about like mica powders. I've never used those before, but they intrigue me. So if you do use them, would you comment in this section and tell me how, what you like, what you use them on? Because I would like to learn more about them. And that's what I love about YouTube and Facebook, is learning from everyone. My family was like, why are you showing your technique on YouTube? Because then everybody's going to be able to do exactly what you do. Which, I mean, it's art. We, you know, we all copied from somebody. You know. It's not like all of this just came out of my lovely brain. So, and with fluid art, you can use the same technique and still get completely differing results. I mean, it's just like, you know, you go to those paint parties at those, all those stores that are popping up, you know, the wine and paint parties, and they give you, you all paint the same picture, but then you see the picture of everybody holding up their painting, and everybody's looks different. So I mean, if people didn't share their techniques with me, there's a lot of stuff I wouldn't know how to do. So, another tangent. Okay, so I'm gonna take my hammer, I'm going to hit right in the middle. But I like what's going on though, and I'm glad I put the blue down first, because it really stands against the gray, although when I hit it, I really can't tell you what's going to happen. Alright. So normally I would just keep smacking the crap out of it, but I'm going to let it sit 1 minute, well not actually a minute because I'm impatient, so sit like 5 seconds to see where I feel the paint is going to be moving. And it doesn't seem to be doing much at all, which is good. So, oh, and I should have left it alone. Look at that. Well, crap. I should have left it, because now the gray has taken over. So I am going to make new puddles. I'm trying to decide if I should swipe any of this off. Take and see what's gonna happen. Get some of this color off here. And I don't have anything covered, and I'll probably end up saying awful curse words that will make your ears cry. You can see from the swipe of the other one all the colors puddling up, but that's okay. It's all about the experiment. Gosh, alright, I'm gonna use the mallet. Oh my gosh, this is just gonna be a mess. I'm gonna try and hit it gently. What the heck is that? I have no idea what that was. That just... Oh, you know what it was? I'm gonna take the saran wrap off of here. Because I hadn't... Oh. Came from my mallet. I think my mallet needs a good scrubbing. I cover it. But it doesn't seem to be doing so well. I don't know what's going on with it, but I'll quit staring at it and get back to painting. Ew, it doesn't smell very good either. Something happened to the rubber in it, which is quite odd. Weird. Anyhow, we're not gonna continue to discuss the rubber on my mallet. That sounds weird. So many things in this art form sound really, really weird taken out of context. Some more. And this time I am not going to, I'm not going to smack it. I'm just going to kind of gently go through the motion. Wipe it off. I'm not really sure what's going on with this. But I don't like it, because it's not doing anything. So maybe it's just very difficult working against the gray background, which very well could be. So I'm going to pour some of this off. And I'm going to do an impromptu, well, you know what? I may just tilt on this. See what? No. This one's a goner. Total goner. Where'd this go? Alright. Bye-bye. See you later. Okay. I need to. That didn't work, obviously. So we're going to do, I'm just going to do a flip and drag. Hang on, I got something I'm using. Yes, a pill bottle. It occurred to me as I was throwing this away, these away, that I could, you know, recycle them. So I'm gonna spritz some silicone in there. We're gonna do purple. Let's see what is this. This isn't even a fun drug. And pink. Just set that down on there. Actually, I'm not. I should probably, like, for privacy's sake or something, cover up. You know. So all you people don't. Can't track me down by my drugs. Because that allergy pill that I take is really exciting. I suppose it has my address on there. And you know, I'm going to become such a famous artist that I don't want you all flocking to my home. Because that would scare the dog. I hope you guys don't mind that I just kind of blather and blather and blather. But you really can't answer me out loud right now, so it's just gonna be that way. Alright, I have got this. I have no idea how many ounces a pill bottle is. But I have it maybe a quarter of the way full. I kind of want to add some white. I'm trying to think, if I put it on top, it's going to end up on the bottom first. Science, people, science. All right. No, I don't think I'm going to do a flip and drag. I think I'm just going to do a flip. You can see, since this gray was, it's not a solid gray, it was white and black, and you can sort of see it threading through. So I'm just gonna go up. Move it around slowly, slowly. I'm gonna drag it a little. All right, now that is some cool cell action going. Right there, can you see that, guys? That is some really funky action. I almost don't want to tilt it at all. Kind of want to see, as the paint levels out, what direction it's going in. This part will need something done, because there we go. That just seemed. And I'm going to have to tilt it somewhat, because it's way too thick. Plus it looks like, just for aesthetic, it needs to go out a little. But it's looking pretty good.